So, hello everyone, my name is Ritesh and today I'll discuss the current affairs topic and today we'll discuss the dam bill which has been passed by Rajya Sabha recently, right? So, we'll discuss this bill which is Dam Safety Bill 2019. Now, I'll give you an overview of this whole bill, right? So, first we'll discuss why this bill was in news, why you have heard this kind of bill in your news, in your newspaper, right? Then we'll discuss the features of this bill, right? If this bill has been passed, there are certain provisions that has been, certain features attached to this bill, right? So, we'll discuss the features of this bill, then the significance of this whole move to enacting such law, right? And then the concerns, right? There's an act that comes with respect to dams. Now there must be a certain issues that has not been resolved in this act, right? So we'll discuss that two concerns and what are the need for this act? What is the basic need for adopting such an act, Dam Safety Bill? So we'll discuss this too. That's it for the whole topic. So let us start with the Dam Safety Bill, that why it was in news. So Rajya Sabha has actually passed the bill, that's why this was in news. Rajya Sabha recently has passed this Dam Safety Bill 2019, so that's why you have read so much about Dam Safety Bill, right? So let's now discuss the features of this bill, right? So first feature is that the bill provides for proper surveillance, inspection, operation and maintenance of all specified dams in the country to ensure their safe functioning, right? So if you just have a general understanding over the whole bill, that the bill is known as Dam Safety Bill, right? So the first feature is to the bill provides insurance, ensure that there must be proper surveillance of those dams that are being constructed, right? There must be inspection of those dams, right? There's a ma proper maintenance of all these dams in our country. Right, so if a dam is being constructed over a certain area, now there are so many aspects involved in this. There are people safety is involved in this. There are people that are involved in constructing a dam. So how the people will get affected if there's a certain if a certain danger is involved in the whole process, then how you will deal all these dangerous activities with respect to the dam, right? Now how you will ensure the proper functioning of the whole dam, right? So the bill provides all these things in the Dam Safety Bill, right? Next one is the bill provides for a constitution of a national committee on dam safety. Now the bill provides a constitution of a national committee on dam safety. There's a committee on dam safety, which is known as National Committee on Dam Safety, which shall evolve dam safety policy. See, this committee will evolve such new dam policies, safety policies with again. The whole dam safety bill revolves around the maintenance, surveillance, inspection of the bill of the dam and the people that are being affected by these dams. That if a dam is being constructed, no one will get hampered by this, no one will get killed by such kind of activities, right? So the whole bill revolves around that, so that the bill, so that's why the bill provides a committee for that, National Committee on Dam Safety, so that this committee will properly inspect all these things in a regular basis, right? So the committee also recommend necessary regulations which may be required as it is a dynamic thing, right? Things will get changed over the years, so the bill, so the committee will also be a dynamic one. They will change regulations, they will amend the regulations if there's a certain thing that have to be amended with time, right? So the National Committee will cover all those things with related to dam safety. Next is the bill provides for establishment of a National Dam Safety Authority. See, first one is National Committee on Dam Safety. Ne then second one is the bill provides for a da National Dam Safety Authority, right? Now this is a regulatory body and which shall have this functions to implement the policy. Now the National Committee on Dam Safety will recommend certain policies, will recommend regulations with respect to that, but this must be an authority which implement all those regulations. So National Dam Safety Authority is the one which implement all these policy guidelines and standards for dam safety in our country, right? So these things, two things you have to consider, because it is these two things are covered under this act, right? Next is, the bill provides for a constitution of a state committee on dam safety by state government. See, first one is national. See, these two things are national committee and national authority. Now, there are also dams are being constructed in states or even, right? So there also must be a state committee on dam safety, right? Because state government will also have power to discharge these functions, and state government, because the people of the state will get hampered now. So state committee will also provide such kind of regulations and such kind of like recommendations with respect to the, because state is very well aware of the peoples affected, right? They can recommend certain things to national committee, and then they will provide the regulations, and they will provide an amendment to the act if there is a certain loophole in the whole act, right? So these three things you have to consider: National Committee on Dam Safety, State Committee on Dam Safety, and there's an authority called National Dam Safety Authority, which will implement the policies, those suggested by state and the National Committee, right? Next, we'll discuss the significance of this move. Now, this, let's discuss the significance. See, when you read significance of an act, or even what is the need for this act, right? So these kind of things are important for your comprehension skills. If you know all these things, you will easily go through the whole comprehension very easily, right? You will be like 2 minutes, you will take 2 minutes to just read the whole comprehension if you know all the significance and need for this act, right? So let's discuss the significance first. So the bill will help all the states and union territories of India to adopt uniform dam safety procedures, right? So this bill will help all the states and union territories of India to adopt a uniform guideline, uniform safety procedures, right? Which will ensure safety of dams and safeguard benefits for such dams, right? So the bill recommends a uniform procedure, uniform dam safety procedure for all the states combined, right? So this is important. Adopt dam. So this is a significance. This is also a feature that there's a uniform dam safety procedure under this bill. Second is, this will also help in safeguarding human life, livestock and property. See, when a dam, suppose when a dam is getting affected, or when a dam is very loosely built, or there's a danger involved in constructing a dam. If that happens, there are so many peoples that get affected from this. There are so many lands, or there are so many like livestock and property that are getting hampered by the construction of a dam, right? So the bill will help in safeguarding all those issues that are being affected by constructing a dam, right? Such as human life, livestock and property, right? Next is, the bill addresses all issues concerning dam safety. So the bill itself called Dam Safety Bill. So it will address all the issues concerning dam safety, which include what? Regular inspection of dam, emergency action plan, comprehensive dam safety review, adequate repair and maintenance funds. See, while constructing a dam, there are so many aspects involved in this. Like if you construct a dam, you have to regularly inspect those things. You have some emergency plan if some things happen. There must be some fund for the maintenance and repair of these dams. So the bill combinedly focuses all those things under this bill, right? Last is, it lays onus of dam safety on the dam owner and provides for penal provisions for commission and omission of certain acts. Now the bill says that the onus of dam safety, the responsibility of dam safety is on the dam owner, and if a certain thing happens, it has penal provisions too. That means it has certain punishment for these acts too. So again, this thing covers even the safety concerns. Even the owner cannot escape from the liability of constructing a bad dam, and because it has provisions of penal provisions, like it gives penalty, it gives punishment for certain negative acts by the dam owner, right? So these are the significance of this bill. Last is, Next is concerns. Now, you know that there are certain concerns with respect to this bill. Let's discuss the concern over this whole bill. Now, the bill is too focused on structural safety and not on operational safety. See, the first concern is that the whole bill, dam safety bill, basically focused on structural safety, how you construct a dam, how you will enhance, how you repair, and all those things, but not an operational safety, right? How these things manage. So the bill have to maintain balance between these things, structural safety and operational safety. So you have to, the bill also will have to consider these two things simultaneously, that is structural safety with operational safety. Right. Next is this inadequate compensation to the people affected by dams. Now, the bill has provisions, penal provisions with respect to the negative acts by the owner and all those things. Now, there are certain people that are getting affected by this dam. Now, the second issue is that the compensation of to the people affected by this dam is quite low. So the inadequate compensation is the next concern with respect to this bill, that you have to give certain compensation which is very relevant and which is good enough for these people, right? So inadequate compensation is the next concern. Next is there is need for an independent regulator as well as for precise definition of stakeholders, right? So the bill also have to consider an independent regulator with respect to the dam safety bill, and also give a precise definition of stakeholders. Stakeholders means the peoples involved in the whole dam construction, like all those peoples that are getting affected and that are being concerned with this dam are the stakeholders. So the bill also have to define the stakeholders, right? You have to define what is the stakeholders in this whole process. What is the stakeholder in this whole dam issue? So definition of stakeholders is the next concern. Then many states say it encroaches upon the sovereignty of states to manage their dams and violates the principle of federalism enshrined in the constitution. Now the bill, many states are arguing So many states are arguing that in the bill, the dam safety bill encroaches upon the sovereignty of states to maintain these dams, right? So the center will take over all these things and do all these perspective plan. There's an authority on national, which is related to national authority, right? Which will implement this. Now the states' power will get hampered by the center. So states are arguing that they are encroaching upon our power. Same happened in farm laws too, that states were saying that they are encroaching upon our powers, they are encroaching upon the state list that are state center is governing all those issues in the state list too, right? So in this two states are arguing that they center is encroaching upon the sovereignty of states, right, to manage their dams, right? Now next is this state, it is as an attempt by the center to consolidate power in the guise of safety concern. See, states are saying that by saying just a safety concern, center are taking powers from the state governments just by saying that there's a safety concern with related to the dam. Now state government can also do these things, right? So states are saying that, okay, don't just transfer all our powers in your hands. We can also manage this whole thing. If you are taking safety concerns, we can also manage these safety concerns within our government, right? So states have this issue with respect to this bill. Now, what is the need for this bill, right? See, again, dam safety concern, because there are safety concerns with respect to the construction of a dam. That is why we need such kind of bill to ensure safety of all those peoples that are being affected by this bill, right? Now, over the last 50 years, these are data, India has invested substantially in dams and related infrastructures and ranks third after USA and China in the number of large dams. Now 5,254 large dams are in operation in the country currently, and another 447 are under construction. Now there's so much money involved in the construction of dams. You can see from these facts that after in USA and India, India ranked third with respect to the dam construction. Now, there are so many dams that are operational in the country, and there are so many dams that are actually being constructed, that are under construction. Now, if these kind of things are happening so frequently, you have to enhance our act, you have to implement an act which regulate all these activities. That is why we need such kind of act, right? So this is basically an argument with related to the factual, actually data are being given to justify this, that is why we need an act, right? Next is, while dams have played a key role in fostering rapid and sustained agricultural growth and development in India, there has been a long felt need for a uniform law. Again, dams affect the agricultural activities because they regulate the waters of these rivers, right? So agricultural activities are being hampered by this. So there must be a uniform law that covers an administrative structure for ensuring dam safety, right? That is why we need this kind of law. Next is the Central Water Commission through the National Commission on Committee on Dam Safety. Central Dam Safety Organization and State Dam Safety Organization has been making constant endeavors in this direction, but these organizations do not have any statutory powers and are only advisory in nature. See, this point is saying that there are so many bodies, organizations that are being involved in this whole process. But what happens is they don't have such powers. They only have advisory powers in these sectors. So what happened is they can't do anything. They can only recommend, they can only advise to the government that these things can happen, these things you should do. They can only suggest such things. But if you have a uniform law, you can say that you have to make certain things, because this is what law says. Law says that you have to do certain things and ban certain things. Otherwise, you will have an implication of this, right? So if there are so many organizations that are being doing so much things with respect to this sector, but these are having advisory nature only, so there must be a uniform law which will cover all these aspects in a wide ambit, right? So this was all about the whole topic. So again, you only have to consider what are the committee, state committee, national committee, and the authority involved in this process, right? And the what are the basic features of this, that, and what are the concerns, what are the issues, that there are operational wala issue, right? So you have to remember all these things. There's little factual data. This is all about the committees and authorities with respect to this bill, right? So that's all for this topic, which is Dam Safety Bill 2019. So thank you so much.